It's Peyton Reed. Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm so good. I'm so excited to see you. I almost fell off my platform.
Don't fall off, please. Come on. We don't want any accidents here. We want this to be a safe environment. We can have fun, but be safe.
See, and that's why he's such a good director, right?
Exactly.
This is fantastic. I mean, the Marvel premieres are always amazing. And it's doubly weird when it's your own premiere.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're thrilled.
You're
really thrilled.
Your resume is absolutely bonkers. But
I
believe this is your first sequel, right?
It is my first sequel, yeah.
How difficult was it to follow up a successful film that made over $500 million worldwide?
Well, it's interesting because, you know, I just approached it from, you know, we are all moviegoers and we know what we like and don't like in sequels. So really it was just like, let's try and make it funnier. Let's try and make it more nuts and, you know, kind of keep the things that hopefully people liked about the first movie, like the, you know, the father-daughter stories and the emotion and stuff. So that's really how we approached it.
And you have such an incredible cast. I'm curious, you know, you had some of the same cast coming back. Were there things that you leaned into more because you knew better sort of the abilities and unique talents of them?
Yeah, well, Paul and I talked about, you know, in the first movie, part of it was this was Paul's first time out as an action hero.
Yeah.
Now that we know he's an action hero, it's like, well, we got to make you even funnier in this movie. We got to make you go nuts in this movie. And same with Michael Douglas. I promised Michael, it's like, I know you're Dr. Hank Pym and you're kind of crabby a lot of the time, but let's give you some jokes and let's give you some action. So there were things like that, but it's nice coming back and working with the people you worked before. You know, it's like family.
One of the things that I loved most about the first film was very quietly you made commentary about criminal justice reform, about how we bring ex-cons back into society. Was that a driver for you, or was it just something that just sort of happened by accident?
Well, yeah, I thank you for mentioning that, because it was an important thing when we started talking about the story for this one, how we progress the story of those guys, Scott's friends, Luis and Kurt and Dave, you know, who are all ex-cons. And in this thing, we start them off, you know, they've started their own business, they're small business owners, and that becomes a major part of the plot, you know, which I like that Ant-Man and the Wasp is the kind of movie where there can be all this sort of big Marvel villain stuff going on, but just as important is, you know, is their business going to survive?
And there are amazing sets. Speaking of the big set pieces, there's an amazing set. You've got the lab in this. What was it like walking onto that set for the first time? Because it was on a 15,000-foot soundstage.
Yeah, it was Shepard Frankel, our production designer. He knocked it out of the park. This is the biggest set that Marvel's ever built. And I feel a presence behind me. Who could it possibly be?
I don't know.
I don't know, but it's quite the presence.
Wow.
I just talked to your mom.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, no. This scares me.
Well, I just told her how proud she should be about the job that this guy did. I'm just so impressed. It's a whole new level. I never did one of these big, you know, pictures. How he keeps this whole thing together is quite incredible. So, Peyton, this is your life.
I don't have any cash on me, Michael. But I'll pay you later. Right. Thank you.
Enjoy it, man. I hope you have a good time tonight. Not as sharp as you do.
No,
that's
great.
Just very nice of you, Sue.
I think we have your mom here.
Come on over. Stay with us. Come on over here.
All right, buddy.
We're going to get a photo.
There we are. Photo.
That's fantastic.
My mom. I told you. You thought I was kidding, huh? She goes in the middle.
We were serious when we said that this was a film about family.
Absolutely.
How important family is.